Welcome back to Calculus 1, and welcome to week 15 of our time together. We've been at this since January, and this is it. This is the last week of the course. Well, where are we? Last week, in week 14, we were looking at techniques of integration, and the technique that we focused on was integration by parts. This week, in week 15, we're looking at an application of integration. But which application? There's so many applications of integration that we could be looking at. We could fill up a whole Calculus 2 course with various applications of the integral. Well, the application that we've picked is volume. I think it's a ton of fun to use integrals to calculate the volumes of solid three-dimensional objects. It's fun because it gives us a chance to think geometrically, to think three-dimensionally. But I also think it's important historically. You know, thousands of years ago, the first inklings of a definite integral appeared. You know, people were thinking about taking objects and slicing them into really thin pieces, say infinitesimal pieces, and adding up all those infinitesimal pieces. And the idea is really, really old. So I think it's appropriate that we end this course with something at the very beginning of humankind's grasping towards the definite integral. We're going to end this course with some volume calculations. It's also appropriate that we end this course with a final exam. So the final exam is available right now, and you've got until the beginning of May to finish it. Good luck!